And now, our feature presentation.
G'day blokes on the internet. I'm Gabe.
I'm Scarlett.
And I'm Harry.
And today is a very exciting day, isn't it, Harry and Scarlett?
Indeed, we've got the SpongeBob musical today.
And it's going to be with this theatre company called Stars and the Moon. It's kind of hard to explain, but when we meet the director, he will tell you all about it. Absolutely. Now, if you don't know much about the SpongeBob musical, it's a musical that started in 2016 in Chicago, then became popular on Broadway in 2017. But if you don't believe us, here is a little snippet of the Broadway cast in 2017. Right now, I am in my dressing room. I know you could hear noise, but that doesn't matter. So now, I'm gonna get my makeup done. So, I've got my foundation and my special foundation sponge. Gotta get this open and get my glasses off. Now, it's time for me to transform. This foundation might take a while, and I gotta get my other things done, but come back to me later.
Hi, welcome back to Harry's Interviews. Today, we're interviewing with one of the producers slash directors, Alex. So, Mr. Alex, what has been your favourite direction you've taken for today?
My favourite direction today would have to be confirming that we will say is mayonnaise an instrument instead of Milo. I think that is a quintessential SpongeBob line, and if this musical was lacking it, I would be very upset.
I would have happily kept the Milo thing in. Okay, question two. What has been your favourite song throughout the musical?
Can I take my top five?
Yeah, sure.
My top five, Bikini Bottom Day, When the Going Gets Tough, obviously. I'm Not a Loser, Super Sea Star Savior, and Poor Pirates.
Question three, what's your favorite scene with Plankton, me?
My favorite Plankton scene, can I choose two?
Yes.
I love the one where you alliterate on stage.
Yes.
And we get some nice romantic brass, some romantic lighting, a fireplace. I love that scene. And I love the scene where all four of you gloat as the curtain comes down. The mwahaha.
Inspiration from the cow from Sesame Street. Please laugh for us. That has been Interviews with Harry. We'll see you again next time. Bye-bye.
Ciao.
Would you look at the size of that monster?
Yeah, that stage is really big, mate.
Absolutely, mate. Jeez.
Looks like that's where we're going to perform.
Indeed.
Let's see how many steps it takes to get to the stage. Come on.
All right.
Let's count.
Let's count then.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
A few moments later.
35 steps to get to the stage.
Oh, wow. What do you know? Hey, what if I did this?
Ooh.
You are not a super spot. You are not a super spot.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today we have
Maestro, Karen, and other Karen. So what is your favourite scene out of all the show?
Oh, that's a hard one. Sarah, do you want to go first?
Yeah, absolutely. My favourite scene is when we bring out the lemon-scented avalanche maker because Zoe does a really amazing laugh.
Yes, that's good.
I really like the big guy scene because the music under that is just a fantastic little concerto with the strings and the clarinet that sounds really great.
And don't forget the amazing acting.
And the amazing acting by Harry and Benji and our Karens, of course.
Scarefully. Okay. So, second question. What's your favourite song from the show?
Zoe, what's your favourite song? You have to think about it. You like Best Day Ever a lot, right?
Yeah!
That's a great song. Yeah. I like Poor Pirates. It's my favourite.
I'm really liking When the Going Gets Tough at the moment, but I always love Just a Simple Sponge as well.
Yeah. Second question. Third question. So, what is your favourite Plankton scene?
Oh, I think I said mine. Mine is the big guy one.
Nice.
Yeah.
I would have to say the scene or half scene just before When the Going Gets Tough.
Yes.
That's like, why should we trust you? I love that.
Yes. All right. Thanks for joining us, everyone. We'll see you later.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.
Hi. Welcome back to Interviews with Harry. I'm doing the interviews this time. So over here we have Gabby Green. And what's cool, we have a similar name, Gabriel.
It's very
kind
similar.
Of cool.
Yeah.
So I've got some questions to ask you about the show. One, what's your favourite part about being in Stars and the Moon and being in SpongeBob?
I love that the cast feels like a family and everyone has their castmate and their buddy and everyone is supporting everyone else and it's so much fun. I love coming every single time.
Yeah, that's good. Second question is, what is your most favourite song from the show?
Oh, definitely I'm Not a Loser.
Yeah, I'm not a loser. Yeah. Okay. And third question, would you join Stars in the Moon next year?
Yes, I would, 100%.
Yeah, cool. Well, that's Interviews with Harry for this one. We'll see you next time. Over here on the stage, we have Charlotte conducting the orchestra for the show. Hi, Charlotte.
Greetings, Maestro.
Greetings, Maestro. Okay. Yeah. And we have Corey over there. He's going to make all the sounds for the show. Which is exciting. And hello everyone out there. Woo!
Excuse me, please.
Ruby.
Where's the mock?
Gabe, wave.
Hello, welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today we have the honour person of the show, I don't know, his name is Eitan.
Hello Internet Squad, I am very excited to be back on the vlogs.
Yes, awesome. So, first question, what is Stars in the Moon?
What is going on here? It's a great question. Stars in the Moon is a new theatre company, and we're an all abilities theatre company, which means that we have some people with disabilities, some people without disabilities, and we're all together in our cast on stage. And this year we're doing the SpongeBob musical.
Second question, what's your favourite scene?
In the whole show?
Yes.
That is a hard question. My favourite scene is at the end of the show, and I think you know what scene I'm talking about, but I don't want to spoil it. So I'll just say that, it's at the end of the show.
Okay, third question, what's your favourite plankton scene?
My favourite plankton scene is when you guys all do your gloating all together and you go, mwah, ha, ha. That's my favourite scene.
Once again, inspiration from the count, play it back.
Watch. This task force is for losers. I've got the perfect plan.
Right now the getting's good, so let's get out while we can. Look, lava's pretty hot. Let's give in to our fear. Disaster's on its way, that means we can't spend no more time in here.
You'll know who I am! Evil genius, giant brain. You can't stop a volcano, I mean, you all insane! The ones who stay will all be vaporized without a doubt before that sucker blows. We gotta get the fish out.
Fish out, fish out, fish out.
So let go and be gone.
I'll let go and be gone.
I'll let go and be gone.
I let go, and we're out.
Cause when the going gets tough, that means it's time to get loud. When the going gets tough, that means it's time to get loud. So let go,
and we gone, let me go.
I am simply shocked. Bikini Bottom is our home. I can't believe you talk about just walking out. Let's figure out a way to stay today, tomorrow. I feel sorrow, I feel fear, but I'm not leaving here.
Fascinating.
The Freikot has a plan. Good luck with that, cause I'll be gone.
Oh, you don't just wait around cause you're under attack. No, you
got like crazy out the back.
Got one day left, golden pack. Cause when the going gets tough,
when the going gets
tough, that means it's
time to get lost.
When the going gets tough, that means it's time to get lost. So let go and be gone, let's be gone.
Of course, mass evacuation is no simple fate. We'll have to leave together in a vessel that can trap us all. I mean, fit us all. A giant escape pod.
This pod will take us far away from here. We'll build a new home. We'll call it...
Bikini Line.
Bikini Wax! Brazilian!
No! Chumville.
Oh, the because we're all chums.
Hold on, tiny dancer. I wasn't hatched yesterday.
Oh, no.
This sounds like another one of your schemes.
At a time like this, how could you think such a thing?
You have something up your sleeve.
I'm a one-celled organism. I don't even have sleeves!
Ah!
What's this, Karen? Break it down now.
More me, twin threading vision never had it, so I had to be a devastating conversation, luminous communicator, hoping later every hit of the side, a little tiny me, okay, you never heard of me, okay, I'm a giant, I'm a giving up a limiter, floating in a saline, ready for the bailing, cause I have a celebrating single cell, silly and terrible genius!
I'll let go, and be gone,
and today we have Ruby, who is playing SpongeBob alongside Gabe.
Hello.
And Zach, who is playing Squidward.
Yes.
And is also Eitan's cousin.
Yeah.
So today I'll be asking you guys three questions. So question number one, what has been your favorite song from the musical?
I know this song.
Fair enough. I think mine's actually Super City Star Savior. I love the good gospel choir situation happening. It's cool. Nice. Question two. What's your favorite scene from the musical?
Favorite scene? Do you have a favorite scene?
Gabe and Ruby's son. Oh, stop it. I think definitely some of the Mount Humongous scenes are really cool. They're like very scary. I like them a lot.
Yep.
Nice choice. And last question. What is your favorite SpongeBob and Squidward moment? Do you have a favourite SpongeBob moment?
I know Lisa. Yeah.
I think my favourite SpongeBob moment is with Gabe in Simple Sponge, because I feel like we really stick together then, and we feel like we can accomplish anything.
Yep.
Nice. All right, thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Nice to see you guys.
Okay.
Okay. You gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, corns and all. But first, we need your help.
If the world is gonna end tomorrow, wallowing in sorrow isn't where I wanna be.
Cause there isn't a catastrophe that could ever measure up to me. Sandy, just try it and see. Come on.
What? What?
Hero is our middle name. Fixing trouble is my game.
It's a good game.
Man is Jennifer, and nobody believes my science is real.
Your machines, they made a real prediction. It's not science fiction,
but no one wants to listen at all. When the writing's on that old sea wall, but your friends need you to heed the call.
All the one and one for all. Come on,
yeah.
Hero is our middle name.
No, it's not. We just went over that.
And we need you. Patrick can help climb the volcano.
You have to handle the stopping it from erupting part.
And we have no clue how.
Because time is running out really, really fast.
But no pressure.
Pressure! Yes! I think I have an idea. Figure one. Diagram the volcano eruption caused by rapid expansion building up in the subterranean magma chamber. Figure two. If this pressure is released, no eruption. Into the mouth of the volcano. Figure four, with a time and set to detonate in the past moment of eruption. Figure five, unleashing a deadly bubble that will stop the explosion and prevent the blast.
You lost me at one.
The point is, this could work. I reckon I could have that bubble device built by tomorrow morning.
So you stay and help us?
Boys, I'm still gonna push on from this town of yours. But you are my friends. So first, I say let's give this idea a shot!
Three heroes to the rescue!
Team of Trace to the top!
And today we're interviewing Devin, and he plays in the show Mr. Krabs. So, Devin, tell us, what do you like about being in Stars and Moon and being in SpongeBob?
I just love performing with all of these incredible people. Mm-hmm. Everyone in the cast and the production team are all just unbelievable humans. So I really enjoy spending time and spending time with them on stage and behind stage.
Interesting.
And singing.
Okay, secondly. What do you like about being Mr. Krabs?
Oh, it's the voice. It's like
getting back into the roots of the grit and the ugliness of it.
Yeah, when you hear the voice, it sounds a bit like a pirate.
Kind of. That was my instruction from the cameraman, was to be a pirate.
Yeah. You're speaking of pirates, Patchy's about to go on stage soon.
I'm excited to see Patchy.
And third question. Would you be in Stars and the Moon again next year?
Oh, it's a big question. I hope so. I really hope so. I just have to see if my university lets me.
That's all right. Yeah. Well, that was Interviews with Harry. I'll see you later.
See you guys.
Hi. Welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today, we have gotten... welcome back, Sarah. And we've got Kaylee over here. So, you guys, first question. What's your favourite song in the show?
Do you want to go first?
I think I like Super Sister Savior.
Nice.
I think my favourite is either Best Day Ever or Bikini Bottom Boogie, because that's our time to shine, so that's really fun.
Okay. Second question. What's your favourite SpongeBob scene?
I really like when the SpongeBobs do the Simple Sponge song again, and they go, I am not, I am not, I am not a simple sponge. I love that one.
I think I like when they're climbing up the mountain with the steam, with the smoke and all the lights and sounds. I think that's really cool.
Okay, third question. What's your favourite plankton scene?
When the going gets tough.
Same, when the going gets tough by far. Right. That's like the best ever.
See you later.
See you.
SpongeBob, we can't give up now.
Yeah.
ever.
Hi, welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today we have Sandy Cheeks, also known as Sophie.
Hello, nice to have me. Thank you.
And it's really nice to have you here. So, what is some of the best musicals that you've ever performed at?
So, I would say my favourite musical I've ever performed in would be High School Musical. I was very lucky enough to play the role of Gabriella.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was just such a fun musical to be involved in. Yeah, it was great. And who doesn't like High School Musical? So I would say that was my favourite one I've been in.
Now, question number two. What's your favourite scene out of this SpongeBob musical?
Okay, my favourite scene would have to be Best Day Ever, because it's the part in the musical where SpongeBob is sort of lifting up everyone's spirits and is like, although we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, this could still be the best day ever, and we all like have each other there to like support each other through the day. So I think that would be like my favourite scene.
Question three.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favourite scene with me, Plankton?
Oh no. How could I even choose one, Harry? Always trying to ruin me. Let me think. What scenes are we specifically? Oh, I guess favorite scene. Maybe The Going Gets Tough, because that's just a really fun song to be involved in.
Excellent.
Yeah.
All right, that has been interview with
Pepper.
That has been interviews with Harry. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present Electric Skate!
Are you excited to rock out?
We are so excited to rock out!
Bikini Bottom Booty or not! You guys are gonna rock act too! Yeah! Well, and you know what they say, this show is gonna rock! Okay, let's get ready! This gets going! Okay, let's get ready for Act 2! Woo!
Oh my god, there ah! Hello, Bikini Bottom! Are you ready to rock?
If you wanna rock, feel it alright. Bikini Bottom, look at your night. Getting sweaty, getting sweaty, but I'm loving your time. Bikini Bottom, look at your night.
Ahoy there, Captain Fezzort! Ahoy there, Captain Fezzort!
Ahoy there, me hearties! Woohoo!
Yeah, wearing your pirate hat?
Yes, my pirate hat right on my head.
Well, you gotta go. You gotta get ready for Act 2.
Absolutely. Okay.
See you later.
You're ready?
Let me begin with a hearty ho-ho!
Ho-ho.
And a tale that nobody tells well. I've not come all the way from NCINO to be treated like sewage that smells. Some of us just want adventure! The open sea wind in our earrings. Why are we constantly misunderstood? Don't you know pirates have feelings?
More pirates, D-O-O-R, more pirates, D-O-O-R.
Long John Silver invented the blooming onion!
But do you think he gets credit for that?
No!
Captain Marvel,
no one knows his first name!
And the Green and Big and Gravy!
The Billy Green Insane! And Long Silver is a one holiday!
Today, we have the lovely Michaela. So, Michaela, what has been your favourite choreography you have done?
I think my favourite is probably Go and Get Tough or Chop to Top. Yeah.
Now, what is your favourite song from the show?
My favourite song?
Yes.
Hero is my middle name. But I do love Super Star Saviour, and I love when Netta Nell sings that, so.
Yeah. Right. Third question, what's your favourite plankton scene?
My favourite plankton scene? Oh, it's got to be the rats. It's got to be the rap and Go and Get Tough. And the mwahaha that you do.
I is yeah. Camp from the Sesame Street. Play it back again.
Hi, welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today, we need to give an internet squad welcome back to Jared.
Oh, hey there, how's it going, dudes?
Yeah, but his actual name is actually Zeddy, right?
Oh, that's true. I'm actually from North London, but I'm just being American just for the show, yeah.
Yeah, Zeddy, you are. Oh, all right, true. All right, Jared. Okay, back to your normal voice while I ask you some questions. So, one, what's your favourite part about being Stars on the Moon this year and being in SpongeBob?
Oh, that is such a good question, mate. So, like, this cast, mate, it's so talented. It's such a lovely family. And you're lovely, and you're lovely down there. Oh, hello, lovelies. Yeah. And that's why I'm here. Talent and family.
Yeah, talent and family. Now, second question. What's your favourite song in the show?
Oh, that's a good question. Well, your song, A Simple Sponge, is such an empowering, uplifting number, and I get to be in it. I do a little dance with Ruby, who's the other spongy, and it's so fun. I love that one.
Yeah.
Shall we do a little taste of it?
Maybe not now.
Not now, a bit late.
Okay. And third and last question.
Yes.
Would you do Stars on the Moon next year?
Absolutely!
Yeah! Alright, would you like to get back to Jared's voice now?
Oh, which one?
You know, your regular.
Oh, okay, we're back to normal.
Yeah, well, you did really well with your Zeddy voice, Jared.
Thank you very much.
Alright, well... Well, that was interviews with Harry. We'll move on to the next one later. Bye.
Hi. Welcome back to Interviews with Harry. Today, we have Hillel, aka Mr. Squidward Q Tentacles. Now, Mr. Squidward, first question. What's been your favourite song throughout the show?
Oh, I think I would have to say I'm Not a Loser. It's my big breakout moment of the show.
Excellent.
I get to have a lot of fun, put on a sparkly jacket.
Excellent.
It's really good.
Second question. What's your favourite Squidward scene?
Oh, my Squidward scene. I think I really like the one where he is remembering back to his third grade talent show. And
loser,
it's like he's got this trauma from the kids calling
loser,
him
loser.
Loser, yeah, and it's just this really funny image and that it like puts in my head of him thinking back to his third grade
That's
talent
amazing.
Show.
That's
it's
amazing.
Great. Yeah, it's a good scene.
All right. Third question, what's your favourite plankton scene?
Oh, plankton scene. I have many favourite plankton scenes, but I really, really love when you guys do your evil laugh.
Oh.
And then when all four of you end up doing the
Inspiration.
It's you, the planktons, and the Karens. It's fantastic.
Inspiration from the camp. Play it back again.
Go! Good riddance. Don't let the kelp hit you on the way out.
Me too, honey.
I'm not a loser. I don't secretly hate myself. I'm not singing this to no one. It's not the case that no one cares.
Hi, I fail. I know I'm telling.
When others see me, they can't see that nobody that isn't there. Hold on, that's a triple negative. You can't not see nobody, because I'm not nobody, which can't not be seen. Let me start over.
My life is empty. I know to me hate myself. I see us I am prayer, no I case.
I don't stay.
I do.
I'm not a waste. I'm not all alone in thinking that I am not all alone. Maybe I am a loser.
Me four.
Hey, Squidward.
Huh?
You're not delirious with despair, and you're not calling true things false. Hey, Squidward.
This is what? Weird.
You're not hallucinating this scene, and then the anemone chorus line at all.
I'm not.
You're not a loser. You don't secretly hate yourself. You're not singing this to no one. It's not the case that no one cares. You're not a failure. You do not have talent. When others see you, they can see that nobody that isn't there.
I'm not a loser.
make sure to like, subscribe, and put in the comments below what we should do next.
And turn on notifications for the next video.
And if you kind of saw us, come on in.
Bye.
The internet squad is together. And just remember, you gotta punch that notification bell.
I got the whole.
Yeah. I'll see you guys in the next video.
Well, this is the internet squad signing out.
Bye. Bye.